how do we figure out that there are 65 circles in figure 33, right?
So you take, see how many gets added by, so it's 1, 3, 5.
Okay, so you're counting 1, 3, 5,
7,
and then.
And then
you just keep counting like that, over and over and over until you get to 33?
No.
Thank goodness.
So you see,
what
the pattern.
Graduate from that.
So you see the pattern that's going up by 2.
It's going up by 2. Plus 2, plus 2, plus 2, okay.
Then you take the air, or the, you see, sure how to do it. I forgot the next step, but then I know the next other steps.
Minus.
Oh, yeah, minus like what? You take. 33 minus 1.
Why?
Because that's what you're supposed to do.
This is not
breaking
for our math.
You're breaking
features.
The code.
What
no.
code?
That's for Nisha.
You should never take somebody's explanation without having them explain why and also understanding why. Be able to repeat that explanation to someone else. Okay? And not just by rote, but because you really get it. So you say take 33 and subtract 1. Why would we subtract 1 from 33? Hunter?
Okay, so you subtract 1 from 33 because you're going 32 from 1 to 33. So you're going 32 steps ahead of 1.
32 steps ahead of 1 gets you where?
33.
Okay. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Right. Okay, so let's think of it this way. Like, if I'm at, I'm at figure 1 right now, and I want to get to figure 2, okay? How many steps do I need to take to get there?
32.
Okay, I'll take 2 steps from here. 1, 2. Where am I?
5.
What figure am I on?
Oh, 3.
So 2 steps to get to figure 2?
Yeah.
That would be 1.
Okay, let's start again. We're at figure 1. Let's go to figure 2. How many steps?
1.
1 step. Okay, let's start at figure 1 again. How many steps to get to figure 4?
3.
1, 2, 3 steps to get to figure 4. So, how many steps to get to figure 33?
32.
1, 2, 3, 4. The 32 would put me at 33, right? They already started at 1.
Sure.
How many steps to get to figure X? Remember, an algebra X is just a number that represents,
oh.
or sorry, a letter that represents a number. How many steps to get to figure X?
Number.
So
2
is
two?
Hold on now. I'm asking how many steps do we. To figure out how many steps, should we multiply something by 2 to figure out how many steps it takes to get there? Did you multiply by 2 to figure out it's 32 steps to get to 33?
What?
So, to figure 2, it's 1 step. Figure 3, it's 2 steps. Figure 4, it's 3 steps. Figure 33, it's 32 steps. To get all the way from figure 1 to figure X, how many steps?
X steps.
Okay, let's look at that. So, if X were, say, 3. If I say to get to figure 3, you know, x is 3. If it takes x steps to get to the x figure, then to get to figure 3, it would take 3 steps?
2 steps.
Right? So to get to figure x, would I take x steps to get to x?
No.
Is the number of steps and the number of the figure the same?
No.
Is?
No.
Okay. So another question, please. Is the number of the figure and the number of the steps to get to that figure from 1, is that the same number?
No.
No. So if I want to get to the, just a quick review here, 33rd figure, 32 steps. If I want to get to the X figure, how many steps is it to get to the X figure?
X number of steps.
If it's X number of steps. Like if you say X, X is exactly the same as X.
One.
One step?
One X.
Here, x is equal to 33.
Isn't this pre-calc?
No, it's not at all pre-calc. It is this class.
See, bonus.
It's Stop telling yourselves. Just get over it. Come on. Let's do what I'm asking and stop telling ourselves that it's too high for us or too hard for us. Or let's just think about this. For 33, if x is 33, if that's the number of the figure, how many steps was it to get there?
32 steps.
See, now, if it took x steps, then I would say it takes 33 steps. But it doesn't take 33 steps, it takes 32 steps. Okay, so for x steps, here, let's imagine this. X is just some number. Any, I can say anything. I can say 5, I can say 112. Anything I want. Okay. Now, let's try it with an actual number. I'm going to give you the number 45. How many steps? 44.
44.
Okay, 44. Figure number 45. How many steps would it take to get to 45?
44
steps to get to 45. Okay. Here, how about everybody take out your notes? Take out a piece of paper. Oral, taking notes in school on things that we're clearly getting crystal clear and need no help with. First of all, we can't say it's x steps because x now represents the number of the figure. And the number of steps is not the same as the number of the figure. Okay, so let's maybe call the number of steps y. But there's a way to figure out what y is if I give you x. So again, let's write this down. Write down figure number 97, okay? So write figure 97. Figure 97. Dotted line or something? How many steps does that take?
96.
Did that real quick. I gave you the figure and you found out the number of steps right away, right? We're just going to apply the same logic to any number. Can you take a crack at it, Morgan?
No.
Okay. Yeah?
Say you want to find the
graph.
Yeah. So then it would be x minus y.
X minus y.
Or y minus x.
Or y minus x.
Minus.
Okay. Well, imagine that I'm about to tell you the number of a figure. Do you have a strategy for figuring out how many steps it's going to take to get to that figure?
No.
All right. No? You just randomly guess and hope you're right?
Yeah.
No. I got it.
All right, let's start all over again then.
No.
Start all over again.
Cody.
We can't have people randomly guessing these things.
No, you don't randomly guess it. You want this.
That's what everybody's saying.
I said no.
For the equation, plenty of people said yeah.
For the equation, you put x. All
right, so here we go. Step to get from figure two. Okay, Bella. To get to figure two, huh?
I don't know.
So what should we do?
I don't know.
You go two steps.
Okay, so let's get to the knowing part. The part where we do know.
How am I gonna know if I don't know?
It's called learning.
It's called paying attention. Not
you never learned something you didn't know.
Do you see me on my phone? No, I'm not on my phone.
Hey.
You're one to talk.
You're one to talk. You're on
Stop.
Your phone the whole time.
Or I'm gonna start asking people to leave because you're just distracting from what we're supposed to be doing. Okay? Figure number one. If I want to go from figure number one to figure number three. Bella, how many steps does it take to get to figure number three? If I start here, if I step 1 second to figure two, how many steps would I have to take to get to figure number three?
Two.
Two. One, two. Okay, take two steps. One, two steps. So we'll put steps. So it takes how many steps to get to figure two?
Two.
Two, it takes one step. To get to figure three, it takes how many steps, Bella? You just gave it to us. Two steps. For figure four, How many steps does it take?
Three.
What's that connection between when I tell you what figure and you tell me how many steps it took?
What do you mean?
Like, how do you know? Okay, let me ask you this question. How about figure nine? Like, how many steps would it take to get to figure nine?
Eight.
Eight steps. Okay. Now, how did you figure that it was eight? You were right. How did you?
I just counted up.
Oh, from three. How about if you start? We'll just always start from one. Right.
Right.
So I start at one. And I just take one step to two. Two steps to three. Three steps gets me to four. Nine steps, or sorry, eight steps takes me to nine. Okay. How about figure 23. Bella, how many steps does it take to get to figure 23? What makes you say 22? It doesn't seem like you counted that time.
Well, I'm just going by how, like, it's like one after the actual number. Like, since it's like three and then it's two. Like, sort of.
Right.
I'm just guessing.
Does it make sense that you would, to get to 23, you only have to take 22 steps?
Yes.
Yeah.
Why does that make sense?
Because
23
is after
22.
23
is after 22? Right. So, if we went to figure number, let's just give you another figure number 112, how many steps would it take to get there? 111. Okay. Who else would like to give, take a shot at explaining, maybe in a different way, why it would take just 111 steps to get to figure number 112?
Because 111 plus 1 is.
You're like a step.
Okay, so 111. So, well, maybe I'm just going to reverse it. It's the same thing. But, like, 1 plus 111. Gets me to 112.
Oh.
Makes sense.
Right?
Yeah.
Jasper?
I just say that it's pretty easy if you think of it as like days.
Dates.
I'd
okay.
say it's January 1st, and then on January 25th, you have a big trip. You're not going to say you have 25 days till the big trip. You're going to say you have 24 because you're not including the day you're on.
That
makes
so much
sense.
Nice.
Yeah. So,
I don't get that.
If it's January 1st and I'm going to get January 2nd, that's one day from now. Okay, very good. Very good alternate, an analogy. That's good. So,
oh, yeah.
This is like day one. And here's day 112, which is how many days from now?
111
days. Okay. So, days instead of steps, days from now. I guess days from now instead of steps, days instead of figures.
That makes it so much easier to understand.
Yeah.
First one.
Try Jasper.
Yay, Jasper.
All right. So, so 112, figure 112 is 111 steps down the line from the first figure. Okay. What figure were we talking about?
He's terrible.
Figure number 33. The
whole one? No.
I can't remember.
33
and 52.
Okay,
sorry.
Okay, figure number 33. Or day number 33.
Right.
Is how many steps down the line from figure number one? From figure number one, how many steps do it take to get to figure number 33? 32 steps to get there. Now, every time we take a step, what happens to the figure? It gains two circles. Okay, so every time we take a step, it gains two circles, two circles, two circles, and so on and so on. It'll keep gaining two circles every step we take. And, what we already said this, how many steps do we take? 32. To figure 33, we take 32. So that's 32 times that I'm going to go I'm gonna add two circles. By definition, that's 32 times two. And then what? Well, 32 times 2, that's just how many circles I'm going to add on, right? But how many did I start with?
Oh, you started with 64 and then you added 2.
Well, like in the first figure, we started with 1. I'm going to add 2 onto that. I'm going to add 2 onto that one, add 2 onto that one. The adding on the 2 32 times is right there. There's how much we're adding on. What did we start with? How many circles did we start with?
33.
Started with 1.
And 1.
So we're going to add that 1 on. Like, we, what are we adding it on to? Well, we're adding it on to a figure that had 1 to start with.
Okay. I did 33 times 2 minus 1.
Okay. So let's explain why you did that. As long as it makes sense, then let's do that, okay? For this one, let's review real quick. It takes 32 steps to get to the 33rd figure. That's 2 every time we take a step. That's 33 steps, or sorry, 32 steps of 2, plus the 1 circle that the first figure had. Okay? So, Hallie, why 33 instead of 32? The figure number times the what? Why 2?
Because that's how many it added.
Okay.
And then I subtracted 1 because.
Why minus 1?
Well, because you started with 1.
Okay.
And you're adding 32.
So if I'm gonna go to the figure 33 and I multiply 33 by 2 because I'm adding on 2 every time, I mean, why would I take that 1 away? Don't I want that 1? Why would I take it away? I'm gonna subtract it off. Okay, let's think about this. So if this is because of figure 1, let's use the same logic for the second problem. See if it works. Okay. So if we use the same logic, okay, figure number, what's the figure number here?
It's
52. First figure, second figure, third figure, down, down the line, 52. So if the figure number is 52, different color here. So 52 times what?
2.
2.
Times 2. Why 2? For this guy here.
Wouldn't it be 4 though?
Oh, would it be 4 or would it be 2?
4.
Why 4?
What's the rate going?
That's what I did on my homework.
Oh, okay. So times 4 then. 52 times 4. Figure number 52 times 4 because we add on 4 every time. Okay, so figure number. There's the change. Right there. Okay. Now, let's follow the same logic. You subtracted 1 in this problem because that's how many were in figure 1. We'll subtract 1 because there's 1 also in this figure 1. 52 times 4 is 208.
Yeah.
Minus 1 is 207. But we know it should be how many?
205.
We at least know it should be 205 because telling you what it should be.
Well, that's what I
got
205 on my homework. I don't know.
Remember, we had to add them before we subtracted?
Mm-hmm.
Remember
add before you subtract.
Yeah, remember, they tried to go to 34 before. And then try to go to 34.
I would have to look at my homework.
To get it.
Guys, I'm telling you. Keep relying on your memory of someone's explanation of an algorithm, and you will fail to remember it at some point. An algorithm is a set of steps. Do this, then 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 do this. All right? For, this is
that was third day that we're purposefully, patiently explaining why we do the things we do. Okay. Some of you are telling yourselves, hey, I'll never understand why. I have no idea what he's talking about. I'll just get somebody else to tell me how to do it, and then I'll just always do it that way. You're not going to be able to transfer that understanding to the next topic. You're just going to have to remember another algorithm. Okay? So be patient with me and take the time to understand why. Why is very, very important and very powerful. Tell yourself you can't understand why. It's like the biggest insult you can give yourself. You can understand why. Spending your time doodling on your phone, or talking to other people, or rolling your eyes, or looking at the ceiling, or looking out the window, it's no surprise that you don't understand why. Don't tell yourself that you can't understand why. You can. And that's why we keep going over it and over it and over it. And every time you say, oh, here he goes again, explaining why, I have to ignore all of this. Because that's what I do, I ignore these things because I can't understand why. He's not telling me how to do it every time, so I'll never know how to do it. Forget about how. Think about why. Okay? Let's look at why. So, why would I take 52 times 4? I mean, I see logic in that. It's the 52nd figure. And every figure is 4 more than the one before it. This certainly makes a lot of sense. Okay? But if I do that, I at least knowing the answer, I know that I'm wrong. Because 52 times 4 is 208. It's not 205. So maybe I'll subtract some. How much would I have to subtract?
3.
You have to subtract 3. Okay. But can you explain why you subtract 3? And if you can't, it's not worth your time to use that approach. Can you understand why you subtract 3?
No.
Okay, let's look at it in a different way that I think makes more sense. This way here. Okay? To get from figure number 1, or day number 1, to figure number 2, or day number 2, how many steps is that?
One
step. Okay? And when we go up, what happens to the figure?
It adds 4.
It adds 4. Okay, let's make a little bit of a bigger jump to figure number, let's say it's 5, figure number 5. It's not that far away. We could count up to it if we needed to just to confirm that we're getting it right. So we go from figure 1 to figure 5. How many steps do we have to get up to figure 5?
4
steps. 4 steps. Now what happens every time I take a step? What happens to the figure every time I take a step?
It's 4 more.
It's 4 more. Can we all agree on that? Okay, goes up by 4 steps. Makes sense? Is it brain melting that we go up by 4 steps to get to figure 5? You understand that if we go up 1 step, every 1 step is worth 4 more blocks. Okay. So if I went to from figure 1 to figure 5, how many blocks would I add on in total?
13.
I would add on 4 blocks, 8 blocks, here's figure 4, 12 blocks, 16 blocks. Do I have to count my 4s to figure that out? How can I figure out that it's 16 blocks total added on? 4 steps times 4 blocks per step, 16. 16 more. So how many blocks should be in figure 5?
17.
17. Okay. We're starting at figure 1. Right? We're going to add on 4, 8, 12, 16 more blocks. Add on 16 more blocks. What are we adding that 16 blocks onto? This one block right here. Okay, let's look at the growth of this figure here. Here's figure number 1. How can I get figure number 2?
Add 4 boxes to it.
Where?
At the square. Around.
On every side. So add one here,
add one here, add one here, add one here. Okay? So that's figure number two. How can I get to figure number three?
Add four more boxes on
every, like on the top, right, left, bottom, and left, add another block. Four more blocks. We're watching it grow now. How can I get to the next figure?
Add
four more blocks. One here, one here, one here, and one here. Okay? Every time we're adding on four blocks. So here's figure number one. One. And here's figure number two. And these guys make figure number three. These guys make figure number four. Four. So figure one has one block. How many does figure two have?
Five,
because we add on four, right? Four added on to the one we started with is five blocks. How many does figure three have?
Nine,
because when we add, well, if we add four to the previous five, we get nine. Or if I think of this, if I take the first one and I add on four once, twice, right? That's eight that I'm adding on. That gives me a nine. If we want to get to figure four, I could say, we'll start with the one, and then we're going to add on. How many are we going to add on to get to figure four? Well, four, and then another four, and another four. How many fours are we going to add on to the first figure to get to the fourth figure?
Twelve
blocks, right? Here's the first four, and the second four, and the third four that we add on. Plus three times four. Okay, so 1 plus 12, there's 13 blocks. Okay. So I don't have to go step by step by step. I can say it takes this many steps, and every step is going to add on four more blocks. So let's just add on that multiple of four, right? Agree?
Yes.
All right. Can we get to that conclusion by giggling to each other? Okay, so if I start at figure one, and figure one has one block, figure two is gonna add on four, figure three is gonna be, I would add eight to get to figure three, I would add 12 to get to figure four, I'd add a total of 16 to get to figure five, because I go up four steps, each step is worth four more blocks. Add 16 on to the original one, one plus 16 is 17. We have 17 blocks there. We have to think about that original one. How about figure seven? How many blocks would be in figure seven?
29.
Why 29?
To add on the first block.
To get from figure one to figure seven, how many steps would we take?
Six.
Six times four, right? To go, if we went from figure one to figure seven, seven would have 24 more blocks than figure one would have. Will we add all those onto figure number one? Right? The one block from figure number one, we add on 24 blocks to that. How many blocks does it have?
25.
Okay. Figure four has, well, how many would figure four have in it?
16.
Figure five would have how many?
19.
Okay. How do you know that?
It's going up by three.
It's going up by three? So without having to count and write a bunch of numbers all in a row, so if you can figure out how many are in, figure 21. Figure number 21. Go ahead.
Figure out.